me so special. You got my head spinning like a mental. Hey, yeah, you made me feel special. You got my head spinning like a mental. I can show you my instrumental. You can play along, trascendo. We can even make a song, Brian, you know. 30 minutes long.
Welcome back to BMG TV with your girl Benny. I'm back with a special guest, BM.
Zwa-ma.
He's been saying this all day. I'm just tired of it now, honestly. I'm joking. So, you've got a new album out. It's called Ibibi.
Yeah. Ibibi the album.
Yeah, let's talk about the album. So, how long did that take for you to make? What inspired it? All of that good stuff.
To be honest, the album took quite a while. It took me about, let's say, what, 3 years to make this album? But obviously, I knew that I had to release an album because when you're an artist, it's important for you to have a particular product for you. So, you know, when you're talking to people, you can say, oh, yeah, I've got an album out. You can go check it out, all your songs, blah, blah, blah. Yeah. So I thought, it's about time to release that album. I was going to release that EP, but I thought, no, let me just release that album just so that I have that name. So I put a couple of songs together.
Yeah.
Well, not a couple, but about what, 14, 15? Mm-hmm. And yeah, there it is, BM Baby the album, but it's got some of my top hits
I've done that's going on. Yeah, that everyone knows. Yeah. And let's talk about the My Wife video. You took about, I think it was 2 years. You really take your time to make that music video. Is there a reason why? Was you just making us wait because you thought it'd be funny? Or? Which one? I'll be confused.
It
really
took
2 years to make a music video.
I mean, in life, you go through processes.
There's no excuse.
Listen, okay. You go through a process where you know you want to get something perfect. Mm. My wife, the video had to be 100%. That you can see from the video. If you play the video right now, you watch the video, and you judge for yourself. Tell me what you think about it. You like it? Exactly. If I'd done this video a year or 2 years ago when the song came out, it would not. No, it will nowhere near be what it is right now.
Okay.
What it is right now is quality, and that takes time, it takes money, it takes hard work, preparing everything, because the budget for that video was a lot.
Okay.
The budget was a lot, so, you know, getting the main girl, we flew her in from Poland, and the people from different parts of the world.
Like a really big production then.
And we filmed everything in Paris, so it wasn't like, oh, I'm going to do it here at home, so we had to get a production crew, everybody from Paris. I linked up with Kingdom France. The director, Yannis, he came from Nice.
Oh, shout out to him.
You know, so yeah, there's a lot of
work. Shout out, Yannis. Big
things. A lot of work.
Okay, cool. So, you got a Canada tour coming about soon?
No, I just came from
Canada. Oh, you just came? I'm so sorry. You got a US tour that's coming. But yeah, how was the Canada tour?
Canada was great, obviously the love that I got there, obviously the whole time Delicious Entertainment, you know how you hold it down.
No, shout out, what's going on?
You made everything
shout out
happen.
What's going on? Like,
Canada was great. I performed in Edmonton, Montreal and Toronto.
Okay.
Obviously they were all great. Edmonton was by far the most, it had the most energy.
Yeah, not the crowd, yeah?
Yeah. Montreal was good as well. And Toronto was, you know, was great as well. Like, you know, like, I'll go again.
Yeah,
I'm gonna go again. So
that's really cool how you have like fans all over the world. Do you know what I mean?
I think in music, like, you have to really expand your market. If you live in this country, I live in the UK. I know that not people that see you in the UK, they see you. They're like, oh yeah, that's my guy. That's because they see you in the UK. Mm-hmm. But you're gonna be more appreciated outside of where you're living. Yeah. If you're living in Paris, people outside Paris, they're gonna appreciate you more. And when you go out of the UK, that's when people in the UK start thinking, oh, this guy's traveling, this guy's over there, he's over there, he's doing that.
Yeah.
So you got to really focus around the world. Like when you're selling your songs on platforms like iTunes and streaming on Spotify, you don't want just the UK to be buying the music.
No, of course, yeah.
Because when you expand it to the whole world, you're gonna have, you know, triple, four times, you're gonna get more revenue. So got a focus worldwide because you're not just in this world with the UK.
Yeah, of course. There's more outside of the UK.
Exactly, yeah.
Yeah, I get that. So the USA tour, where are you gonna go in the US?
Yeah, the USA. So obviously shout out Mama Josephine Amerique. And I always do my shout out Mr. Cortel Kenny.
Shout out BNG
as well. Okay. No, I'm gonna show you after. Yeah.
All right.
I'm gonna be performing in Boston. It just got confirmed. Boston just confirmed me. I'm performing in Washington DC and New York.
Wow.
And I just got confirmed that I'm gonna be performing in Ohio, but that's not in March. That's gonna be in April.
Okay. Yeah. That's cool. exciting. New York especially is really exciting. Have you been to America before?
Nah, to be fair, the one thing I'm mostly excited for is going to Queens. He's not coming to America.
You wanna go to Queens?
Coming to America.
Yeah, I've seen that, but
I have to go there and just
you
visit Queens.
You wanna see it in your
I have to see it. I have to be in that street because that video is legendary. It's my favourite film, so I have to just go there and blast through it.
Okay, so the Makulungulu dance, there was a dance tutorial for that, wasn't there? It was CC Coco and another dancer, I forgot her name, I feel so bad. But it was amazing. What's her name?
Aurel.
Yeah, CC Coco and Aurel. How did that come about? Did you organise that, or did just on them two panels said, oh, let's make a dance, and then just made a dance? Like, how was that?
I get these crazy ideas sometimes in my head. I'm thinking, what can go viral? What can make people want to watch something? And I thought, nobody's ever done a tutorial how to dance like a Congolese Ndumbolo kind of style. Yeah. So I thought, let me get together some top dancers, teach them how to dance my tune. At the same time, it's promoting my song and it's also giving the world education how to dance our type of song. Yeah. So yeah, I called CC and Aurel, linked them to up. They were on it, done the whole thing, and boom, it just went viral.
So why did you pick those two girls in particular?
It's not like I picked them, is who was available at the time.
Oh, so did you contact French Manor, or was that just not an option?
No, well,
I mean, because French Manor and CC Coco used to dance together, they have kind of similar styles.
Oh, no, but so obviously at the time I called
and
CC.
I think French Manor is Congolese as well, so that wouldn't make sense.
No, she's not Congolese.
She's not?
No.
Where's she from?
I think she's Ivory Coast.
Ivory Coast?
I don't think she's
Congolese. Oh, she's not Ivory Coast.
But no, at the time I called CC and Aurel because them two were available, and boom, bam, bang, they done it.
Just like that. Okay. Because I also heard, so this is not true, but let me know if it's not true, because it might be true. If it's true, just say. There was rumours that you and CC Coco were dating.
Where did you hear that one?
Do you know, people talk.
Which people?
I'm just some people. Which I can't, people? Can't really say names.
Twitter, Instagram.
A lot of people watching this.
Snapchat. Did you hear it, or did you just think about it right
just
now?
Just rumours.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
No, it's not true.
It's not true?
No.
Okay, because I was going to say, maybe that's why you thought of bringing CC Coco to do that.
No, me and CC are good friends. Me and CC, we've been friends for a long time.
Professionally,
me and CC, we've been friends for a long time. Like, when she started this dancing thing, like, I was there, me and her were talking, I watched her grow, and she's a fantastic dancer, so she's doing well for herself.
Yeah, she's doing good. Cool. So that's not true. Just clarifying, because some people, you know, don't want to confuse anyone.
I don't know which people, but, you know, like, these people
I mean,
need to...
I heard as well that you're a big man, you know, obviously, when you're an artist like yourself, you're big now. Like, you know, you're international, you're going to Canada and US and whatnot, all these other countries, so... There's a lot of ladies who, you know, are interested in, you know, getting with you.
I'm sure,
and stuff like that. Obviously, in the industry, it's normal, like, people, you have professional relationships and they might get unprofessional at times.
But the thing about me is I always keep it professional, especially with people that I work with. It's very important to keep it professional because if you start going to, you know, into it deeply, you're going to fall off and you're going to start, you know, losing friends and your relation with people is going to, you know, break apart. So I keep it professional as I can.
Mm-hmm.
And I can assure you, I've never ever done nothing or been out with anyone that I've worked with.
That's good to know. So,
but I would say that I've got majority of my fans are females. And I do sing a lot of songs.
Most of your songs are about girls.
But
you know, when you sing these songs, are there like anyone that you were like singing them to, or is it just a song?
No, it's just
any
girl
that has inspired you to make these songs that you make?
No, like I can tell you right now, my wife, I done that what, 3 years ago. I was at university in my bedroom. At university, I thought I woke up and I was like, I started playing the keys and I started making the beat and all that, and then I started singing. I was like, oh, this sounds kind of good.
Yeah.
And it came, people say, oh, those looks are so good, like, who'd you sing it for? No, I just made it. When you're creative, you can make anything. You know, the possibilities are endless. You can do anything.
Absolutely.
I'm just creative. Yeah.
Yeah. So you said you were doing uni, yeah? What did you study?
Commercial music.
Commercial music. What's that? What do you have to do with that?
It's basically just studio engineering, producing music, creating, you know, software engineering, stuff like that, basically.
Yeah. So
just making music. I'm a producer. My main Now my main role is a producer. I produce my own songs.
Is that what you did before you became an artist? Was you a producer and then you went into that?
No. Yeah, I was a producer and then I thought, you know when you try to bring people in to do what you want them to do but they can't do it?
You can't do it the way you want it.
So I went up and went on the mic.
So let me show you how it's done. Yeah.
And then I noticed, I was like, actually, I'm kind of good, I'm all right. Yeah. So then that's where it kicked off.
Okay, that's cool. So let's talk about DRT. Mm. Who are the members in that group?
Well, DRT, Hotak Soda, Hotak Melly, obviously my brothers, those two, I started this music thing with. We all started in Karlsruhe College, you know, we had...
Oh, taking it back, yeah?
Yeah, taking it back.
We've done
lots of songs, like commercial songs. And one song that we've done was on the Specsavers advert, which was aired on TV for 2 years. And we mainly focused on commercial music because we wanted to get out there in the UK scene. And then, me and Sona, we was like, oh, Afrobeats came along. We went to university and we started getting involved in the Afrobeat scene. Mm-hmm. And then that's when we just started doing Afrobeats. Sona was doing more Nigerian style Afrobeats, I'm doing more Congolese style Afrobeats, and boom.
Just from there, just kind of blew up.
As you can see in it, like, people like our music. So,
yeah, definitely. So, why did you guys break up? What happened? What was the story behind that?
We didn't break up.
I mean, well, yeah.
DRT was a thing where, like, it's... When you're growing up, you're at college, you're at uni, everybody all is doing their own thing.
Yeah, yeah.
You understand? Mm-hmm. And it's like, it's not like we never actually sat down and said, let's break up.
Yeah.
No, it's like everyone's just doing their own music. Like, Mary was doing rap, I'm doing comedy style, you know, Sona's doing his. And then that's how it just came along. It's never ever like, oh, we broke up. Like, them two dons are my bros. You feel me? Like,
yeah. So you guys still cool now then?
We respect each other's families. To the max, like we.
Of course, you kind of grew up together.
Yeah, we're all family basically. You know, like this music thing wouldn't have happened for me if it wasn't for, you know, the love that we had for each other. DRT, you know, college, making music. You feel me? Like
that's how
all this stuff begins. Like you have to thank people that you've worked with. Understand?
No,
like. But yeah, all of us were still connected. We still talk all the time. Like even Sonny as well. Just recently, we done a remix of my song "Wind It Slow," which is coming out this year. It's going to be a banger. Make sure you lot tuned in because it's gonna go down.
Okay.
And he killed it.
So let's talk about different artists in the UK. Is there any artists that you'd you like or don't like?
To be fair, me when it comes to don't like, I like anyone that makes good music. And to be fair, like, I personally don't really focus on the UK too much. I'm more like...
Are you more international, would you say?
I would say yes. In some aspects, yes. But I'm more in the francophone side of this industry. Like,
okay.
I'm Congolese and I'm trying to basically put Congo on the map. I'm trying to make music.
Because right now it's really just Nigeria everywhere.
I wouldn't say it was in that. No, it's only like in the UK.
Okay, in the
this
UK.
This is the problem that we have. The Congolese community in this country right now, they don't support each other as strong because there's not enough Congolese people in the UK. Not saying that they don't support, they do support, but there's just not enough of us. Go to Paris, on the other hand, there's more Congolese people and Francophone people in Paris, but there's not much Nigerians or Ghanaian in Paris now. Table of turtles.
So it's kind of different where you go. It's like, how do you say, different countries are all different. So like you said, with France, it's more Congolese people, more Congolese artists. Congolese people are more like, known.
Yeah.
Whereas here, it's just, I feel like most of these Afrobeat artists that I have are Nigerian or Ghanaian, and that's all you hear.
And that's...
And I feel like it kind of, sorry to cut you off, but I feel like it kind of makes it hard for Congolese artists to like come up into the Afrobeats like genre of music. Because all people know is Nigerian stuff, Nigerian people.
That's why, like, even when I go on radio interviews here in this country, they're like, oh, how come you get these, this, you got this much fans, you got this much people following you, this much people dancing to the song? And I'm like, yeah, because, you know, I'm not really trying to focus on the UK because it's the wrong crowd here.
Yeah.
The crowd here, unless you make a song with a Nigerian artist or make a song near to their genre, their style of music, then, you know, they'll listen to you. But if you're making Francophone music, like, you really want to be promoting in Francophone areas. France, Belgium, and so on.
Yeah, okay. So, anyone that you want to work with? Any Afrobeat artists or just artists in general from the UK?
I'm open to any artist that's good. good music makes me happy. If you can make good music, then yeah, anyone, you know, it doesn't matter how. Like, I don't ever rate artists as low or high. You know, like, every artist that can make good music, they're artists. You understand?
Okay, so no specific artist, but just anyone who's good at their craft.
Anyone that's good, yeah, that I meet. Obviously, it's about linking up. You can link up with someone right now and you like the style of music. Like, you know, you'll fit my song. Let me get you on my tune. Mm. You get me?
Yeah.
That's how it goes.
That's cool. So you were talking about the Congolese industry and stuff and how people don't really, Congolese people don't really support each other. Have you like had any encounters with people who are Congolese who you kind of felt like they didn't really support your career, family or friends, and you just kind of felt like, yeah, I'm gonna have to leave you there because you're not helping me?
Yeah, no, I mean, in this country, like, I would say that in this country, because there's not enough of us, you have to kind of divert and go and try to conquer a fan base from somewhere.
Mm.
And people from here, they'll see you doing big things elsewhere.
And they're gonna want to,
that's how it happened for me, basically, isn't it? I tried in this country, I tried to get people to follow me and stuff. At first, you know, everyone's just like, what's he doing? Now, everyone, like, when I made my song Makulungulu, I had a lot of people laughing. Makulungulu means bare feet.
Yeah.
Don't say bare feet, by the way. I made my song Makulungulu, and people are like, oh, why is he making a song about bare feet? Now, BM, that's my boy. Obviously, I started back in the days, me and him were rolling, like,
oh gosh.
Obviously, everyone now, they understand it when they see it somewhere else. And that's the thing about Congolese people in this country. Like, I think it's because there's not many of us. We all move in a way like we want to show that, we want to keep ourselves to ourselves and show that we are the real thing by ourselves, but not show too much. Yeah, it's called, we call it fear. You know, explain fear.
How do you explain fear?
Fear is like stunting.
It's stunting.
It's like stunting in your own way. You want to stunt in a way, like,
yeah. It's like let's take it. It's a bit stush. Like you're moving a bit stush. Yeah.
And that's what happens a lot of time in the UK. But the thing is that once you've conquered once you understand how they work, then you'll be fine. Like people start supporting.
Mm-hmm.
It's just about getting people on your side.
No, definitely, because I feel like I'm not going to say anything, but there's some like Congolese artists who, you know, are trying to do that Afrobeats thing in the UK and it's just not really working for them. And I feel like you took the right route by, you know, going to the other countries like France and stuff and Belgium, where obviously the Congolese community is large and, you know, popular and stuff, and people listen to Congolese kind of Afrobeat style music, and then, you know, making a name for yourself in those countries and bringing it back to the UK.
Yeah.
I think that works because now people, you won't even African listen to your music.
Yeah, I mean, that's the thing about me. Like, I like to make commercial African music, music that people can relate to. And,
yeah.
And I think the good thing about Afrobeats right now is that it's not about the language or the sound.
It's the beat, isn't it?
It's, if it makes you dance,
yeah,
then that's it. You get me? Afrobeats is becoming so big right now that if it makes you move, then you've got a hit. It can be commercial. Look at Wizkid is doing big things in America with these Drake and everything. Look at all these Davido collaborating. Look at Cordio Bello just done a feature with Kelly Rowland. Like, right now, yeah, Afrobeats is big because if something makes you dance, makes you want to move, then it's commercial.
Hmm.
You know, people don't care about what they're saying no more. And that's what happened with my song, like a baby. A baby went viral. People just dance it. And obviously, you have to involve some type of English into it.
Of course. Because otherwise you won't understand.
Yeah, English is very important. It's the most dominant language, you know, in the world. And if you involve that and you make people dance, then boom, that's it.
Cool. So where do you see yourself in, let's say, 5 years from now?
To be honest, someone asked me this question 5 years ago.
What did you say 5 years ago? Let's compare your answer 5 years ago and your answer right now. And let's see how far you've come. Can you do that? Do you remember what you said to the person who asked the same question?
I think I wanted to be near enough here.
Okay.
Because I wouldn't have imagined me even having fans like around the world following me, and fans screaming my name and
getting
millions of views and stuff. And so where I am right now, I think is alright. Independently as well,
mm-hmm.
the most important thing as well. Like, I'm not signed. I've never been signed before. Mm-hmm.
Are you looking to get signed? Are you trying to work with any record labels or? Are you just doing your own thing at the moment?
To be fair, like, once you conquered how the record the music industry goes, you can really do it yourself. Right by now, you don't need a record company to back you.
Mm.
If you know how to use, you know, like websites like TuneCore, where they distribute your music and they plug it on platforms, iTunes and Spotify and stuff, you start to understand that, wait, if I just get my own fans, I can make you know, five times the money that a record company would give me.
Yeah, definitely, yeah.
So I don't know, I don't think I'll want to get signed.
Okay. But if the opportunity came,
I've had some opportunities come to me, but I refused them. So it's really like, it's how flexible the record company want to be. If they want to give me, you know, they want to let me do what I want and let me be free to do what I want, then maybe.
Okay.
You feel me? Yeah. Or maybe just singles or an album, signing an album for an album, or, you know, but not like signing my whole career right now. Because I'm much more than, I'm a producer as well. I make music for other people as well. I wouldn't want to just be, you know, owned by a company where you can't do
that. Like stuck in one place.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So last message to your fans. Yeah. What do you have coming up? What are they expecting? What should they be looking out for? All of that good stuff. Let them know.
Yeah, I'm going to America next month in March. So obviously that's Boston, Washington DC and New York. Coming back, then I'm going straight to Germany on the 31st of March. That just got confirmed today, so I'm happy. And then after that I'm going to Paris.
Do you know where in Germany?
Because Germany's a big country. I think it starts with an O, something like that. But
yeah.
And then I'm going to Paris, France, Paris, the Melting Crew show. You know that one's all the big artists in Paris gonna be there, so that's gonna go down. And then I'm going to Holland on the 29th of April,
it's
I think.
Yeah, for him.
No, I'm going back to America on the 15th, you know, on Ohio.
Can't keep up.
But to be fair, I won't lie to you, I don't do much shows in the UK because there's a lot of...
You're still trying to like build your fan base there, don't you? I mean, I think you got a
pretty good. Like, it's to do with the whole crowd. I'm Congolese, isn't it? Like, the shows in the UK is like, there's not many of us in it. But obviously, I've done a lot of shows. I still do a lot of shows where there's opportunities, you know, just to go and represent your country and stuff. But I like to travel.
I can see that.
But I'm still open for any bookings. If you want to book me, you know what to do. BMPro@homo.co.uk. Zwoop!
Right, so you heard it from the man himself. He's going to be in, I'm going to try and remember from the top of my head, America, Holland. America, Germany.
Paris.
America again.
And Holland.
And then Holland, and then back to the UK. So make sure you check him out. That's been it from us, really, yeah.
Yeah, obviously, Hold Tight BNG.
Finally, you get a shout out. I feel so special.
Hold Tight BNG, Hold Tight everyone that's here. It's okay. Like, keep doing what you're doing. Everyone's gonna, you know, rise up. And I like to encourage people, I like to be positive. Whatever you're doing in music, never ever think that, oh, why am I doing this? Think about why you started doing it.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? If you liked it at the start, then you're gonna, the end result, it takes a long time. You know, me, it took me years to even get where I am. But just never stop it. Never stop.
What he said. Alright, then let's say bye to everyone.
Beep it up!